All right. Watch the Throne. I'm excited. It's been a little while since I've listened to Jay-Z. I did Reasonable Doubt. I thought that was a great album. From what I understand with this album is that he has had several albums since Reasonable Doubt up to this one. And then, of course, with Kanye, he's released Dark Twisted Fantasy. That blew up big time. Well, I believe so. Anyway, I don't know what the initial reception of that album was. Anyway, I'm excited because it's been a little while since I listened to some Kanye. That was the last album I heard. I didn't, I had already done Yeezus, so I haven't done Yeezus recently, although I have listened to it a ton, so I'm familiar with that one. Also, I don't even know if this came out before or after Yeezus. And then Jay-Z is another artist I want to get into. Now, hopefully this gets, I can post this on YouTube. The Reasonable Doubt reaction was blocked. There you go. I don't know shit about this album. Looks like there's a lot of people involved. Frank Ocean's on here and Beyonce's on here. Mike Dean is listed in the production credits here, so hopefully there's some guitars here on this first track. But I did get a message on, I think it was Patreon, maybe it was Twitter, somebody saying, "Hey man, just so you know, this album is basically like a victory lap," which makes sense. Given where they're at in their careers, both Kanye and Jay-Z, yeah. You've made it. You're on the top of the mountain. Victory lap. But it was good to know that because coming off of an album like Melt My Eyes by Denzel Curry, which was very introspective and open and dealing with emotions and struggles and stuff like that, it's nice to know where the mindset is for this album so I can kind of adjust my own headspace and be there too because I always have a hard time settling into a new album. Now, what will be neat with this one is that I've obviously know Kanye very well, and I'm familiar with Jay-Z. So I'm hoping the transition into here should be pretty good. This is the deluxe version. For anybody who's wondering, I'll probably forget to put that in the description, but it is the deluxe version. So there you go. I don't really have much else to say other than here we go. Checking out Watch the Throne, a collab between Kanye and Jay-Z, which has got to be, God, this was back in 2011. So that's got to be a huge, huge collaboration. I mean, this must have been significant at the time. I can only imagine. So we'll drop in. Track one is called No Church in the Wild, featuring The Dream, who I don't know, Frank Ocean, who I absolutely love. Production is Omos, Keith, Mike Dean, 88 Keys, and Kanye West. And I'm curious to see if Kanye has produced or at least been involved with production on every track, but we'll see. All right, track one, No Church in the Wild. That's a cool sound already. I like the warp that's on that guitar.
Human beings in a mind. What's a mind to a king? What's a king to a god? What's a god to a
Oh, nice little
non-believer?
turn there. Cool little beat going on. I like this chorus. And that little keyboard portion reminds me of a song. That keyboard portion I was talking about, God, it reminds me of something. I'm assuming it's from 808, that sound, the song I'm thinking of, but I can't remember the name of the song at all right now. And then I can't even remember if I'm actually remembering a song. This little portion here at the end, Jesus was a carpenter, Yeezy laid the beats, Hova flow the Holy Ghost, get the hell up out of your seats. I like that. And then, only the doctors got this. I'm hiding from the police. Rolling on the Rolls-Royce Corniche. Only the doctors got this. I'm hiding from the police. Cocaine seeds all white like I got the thing bleached. I'm wondering if a thug's prayers reach. Yeah. Okay. Let's keep going. Let's keep going. Cool beat though. I like this, like, kind of an ease into the album. God, that feels like something from 808s. And I like that mute.
That's cool.
It's my scripture. To never fuck nobody without telling me.
Cool. Cool stop right there.
Last night was mad real. Sun coming up 5 a.m. I wonder if they got cabs still. What's a guy to a non-believer?
God, that sound right there. It is totally reminding me of a beat. I wish I could remember it. I wonder if it's mentioned in one. It's almost like a circus song, huh? I'm gonna pause it. Looks like it was fading out a little bit, but another thing I wanted to say, it is gonna be fun hearing Kanye again and hearing his some of his lines, because he's got some funny lines. The coke on his skin made it striped like a zebra. So he's getting high as fuck. They're partying. What I like here is the sunglasses in Advil. Last night was mad real. Sun comes up at 5 a.m. I wonder if they got cabs. Oh, cabs still. I was going to say crabs. Cabs still. This portion right here really strikes me because, you know, 808s has happened. All that shit that happened with his mom, with his fiance, Taylor Swift, all that shit. And then he comes roaring back with Dark Twisted Fantasy and get, you know, top of the mountain again. And then Yeezus drops, and Yeezus is just fucking wild. And you know, I'm trying to place myself into the Kanye arc and his life. And I remember talking about how Pinocchio's story was like Kanye dying, and now there's a different version that's alive and running around. And that version, that second version, that party animal version, is alive and well right here. The sunglasses in Advil. Sun coming up at 5 a.m. Like he's not even gonna try and hide it anymore or fight it. You know, he's just in. He's allowed himself to be consumed by whatever you want to call it, the industry or the lifestyle or whatever. And the only reason I'm pointing this out is because while that portion was happening in the song, I was thinking of the music video, but I can't remember which one it is. And it might just be a fan-made one where he's at the bar or the restaurant and he's fucking wasted. Kanye is. And he's like going up to the girls and talking and being all weird to the girls and like getting thrown out. And yeah. Anyway, that's what I was thinking of when I was hearing that portion. Cool song. I saw that it won the a Grammy. Oh, song won the award for best rap song. Yeah, Grammy. Good beat. Good song. Cool jam. Let's move on to track two, which is called Liftoff. It's got Beyonce, who I've not heard. Oh, Pharrell Williams produced it. Mike Dean again, so hopefully there's some guitars. Jeff Basker, Don Jazzy. Q-Tip is familiar. The other two, Don Jazzy and Jeff Basker, are not. And Kanye West, of course. All right, track two is Liftoff. Nice, rich sound already. Definitely giving the vibe of a victory lap.
All engine running.
I think this is going to be my first time hearing Beyonce, too. I don't think I've heard her.
Don't take it to the moon, take it to the stars.
Oh my god. That beat. So many scars. Yeah.
Lift off. Lift off. Taking my coat off. Showing my tattoos. I'm such a show off. Huh. I feel the pain and then roll off. I got the whole city. They about to go off. How many niggas with me?
God, that beat. That beat when it drops in, man, is good. Yeah, very cool. Fuck yeah. All kinds of rumbling going on in here, man. Not a whole lot to say about the lyrics. You know, they're just straightforward, pretty easy. But The production is like over the fucking top in a good way, in a good way. Lots of just rich sound. You know, there, how many people are listed as the production? Like 5, 6? Well, you can tell, yeah, they produce the shit out of this one, man. And you can just, I mean, I feel like my headphones are rumbling around. This is fucking great. Just incredible sound. Great, great sounds. God, that beat right there is crazy. How many people you know can take it this
far? T-minus 15 seconds.
Here we go. 12. Our liftoff sequence. 10,
9. Ignition sequence start.
God, that bass 5, is great.
4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
You know, with that bass, so often I'm used to hearing bass with a lot of distortion, and I love distortion. You guys know I love distortion, but that section right there, the bass was so clean, you know, and it was so smooth. It was just like rich instead of distorted. It's fucking fantastic. This is cool because, you know, usually I get so focused on the lyrics and people are like, you got to listen to the music more. I can't ignore the music right now. It's just, it's fucking 100% present. It's really, really good. Cool little change up to the beat here too. Oh yeah, this is cool. Kind of chill it out a little bit. Put a neat little drum beat in. Pause it there. That was great. I mean, you know what's really cool with this is going into it, Jay-Z, Kanye West, you know it's going to be top tier production quality sound going on. And but you can tell, even, you know, they're not resting on their own names. They're not resting on their laurels, right? As the saying goes. They're going, I feel like after just these two tracks, these two guys came in and said, you know what? We're going to get together. We're going to make the fucking, you know, we're going to make the greatest album of all time, best collab of all time, you know, just going in full throttle. But at the same time, putting in the effort, everything they can do to no shit do that, rather than just a hype where, oh, it's me and Jay-Z, you know, instead of just promoting like that, like, no, actually going in and putting the work in to live up to it, which is cool. And so far, I think it's landing. Track 3 is called Nick. You thought I was going to say it. You thought I was going to say it. Probably not. You probably didn't think I was going to say it. This was a great joke on the Q&A that I had, I don't know, months ago with my wife. One of the questions was, who was in Paris? And at the time, my wife and I had no idea what the joke was referring to. And so she was like, well, we went to Paris. I was like, oh, yeah, we went to Paris. Yeah. That's kind of fun. Anyway, track 3. I will call it Individuals in Paris. Here we go.
We're going to skate to one song only.
Ball so hard, motherfucker. Let's say produced by Anthony Kalafer, Hit Boy. Uh oh, shit. And two more. Mike Dean, Kanye West. Okay. I hope Mike Dean's throughout the whole album. That'd be great.
So hard, motherfuckers want to find me. First niggas got to find me. What's 50 grand to a motherfucker like me? Can you please remind me? Ball so hard, this shit crazy. Y'all don't know that, don't shit phase. And as we go, 0 for 82, when I look at you like this shit gravy. You escape, but I escape. You be in Paris getting fucked up too. Ball so hard, this shit faded. Libraries for like 6 days. Gold bottles, skull models, spilling ace on my sick gays. Ball so hard, bitch, behave. Just might let you meet gay. Shot towns, D-Rose, moving the next, BK. Ball so hard, motherfuckers wanna find me. That shit crack. That shit crack. That shit
crack. I like how on that chorus portion, that drum beat, when it comes in, they put a layer of distortion over it because this the rest of the beat's pretty clean and clear. So that's a nice contrast in sound with just kind of the echoey, distorted, almost like a trash can drum beat. I mean, it's not a trash can, but you know, it's got that just like clanging, slamming type of sound to it. This is, you know, this is what's cool about this album is it's just, you know, good entertaining lines, right? Where the fuck was it? I liked the portion down here. If you escaped what I escaped, you'd be in Paris getting fucked up too. Like, I like that because it puts a little context into the whole party scene. You know, it's one thing to just party or whatever, but to me, there's a little bit more substance to it when it's like, you know, like like surviving, you know, or like, you know, completing something that was difficult. You know, it's fun to just party, but there's more so when it is like a sort of a victory rather than just a party. I like this, like, you know, cycle. I'm liable to go Michael, take your pick, either Jackson or Tyson or Jordan, game six. I like that. This shit's weird. We ain't even supposed to be here. Oh, God. Gold bottles, scold models. Spilling ace of my slick J's. Bitch behave. All right, let's keep going. Let's keep going.
She said, yeah, can we get married at the mall? I said, look, you need to crawl for your bar. Come and meet me in the bathroom style. And show me why you deserve to have it.
Oh, my God.
Ball so hard that she crack. That she crack. Ain't it, Jay? Ball so hard. What she order? What she order? Fish fillet. Ball so hard, motherfuckers want to find me.
Ah, oh, nice. Nice hit right there. Nice hit. Yeah.
You are now watching the throne. Don't let me get in my zone. Don't let me get
in
my zone.
Ah, cool.
Don't let me get in my zone. These other niggas is lying.
This is cool.
Like summer ain't mine. I got that hot bitch in my home. You know how many hot bitches I own.
God damn, dude. The production, I mean, so far the production is just fantastic. Fantastic. And, you know, I was thinking too, because I've had discussions with people recently, either recording for sessions of conversation with the community or just in general, like, you know, in Discord or comments and stuff like that, talking about, you know, okay, there's deep, meaningful music. There's entertaining music. You know, there's such a range that exists there. And what I'm really enjoying here, and I think a big part of it is just my own tastes developing, evolving with hip hop and the music that exists within rap, is I'm really starting to appreciate production, and the production so far is top notch. You can tell these guys fucking put the work in. That end section there when the bass comes in and then you've got that like static beat, that shit was great. It kind of reminds me of Nine Inch Nails a little bit. Trent Reznor would do that quite a bit, where he'd have like these staticky sound beats that were coming in. But then there's even the piano too. The piano is deep and rich. So it's just fucking great layers of sound. Great layers of sound. Good track. No wonder people wanted to know who was in Paris. That's a great question. Yeah. Yeah. Now we know why there was so much intrigue. All right. Track four is going to be Otis, featuring Otis Redding, who is not familiar to me, and it was only produced by Kanye, so that's kind of interesting.
It makes it easier to bear.
Some guitar. Yeah. Fuck yeah. Yeah. It's a fucking piano.
Sounds so soulful, don't you agree? I invented sweat. Popping bottles, putting supermodels in the cab. Proof. I guess I got my swagger back. I adopted these niggas, put a drum in them. Now I'm about to make them tuck their whole summer in. They say I'm crazy, but I'm about to go dumb again. They ain't see me cause I pulled up in my other bins. Last week I was in my other bins. Throw your diamonds up, cause we in this bitch another again.
Photo shoot fresh, looking like wealth. I'm about to call a paparazzi on myself. Live from the Mercer. Run up on Yeezy the wrong way, I might murk it.
It's hard to pause cause they just keep going, which is cool. I was going to say with this track, you know, what they're talking about, all this different stuff. I remember seeing comments from the Drake reaction I did on, I forget the name of the album. Take Care. Take Care. And one of the things people said was, you know, the things that they got into when listening to Drake was there's kind of like a living vicariously through him. I'm totally getting that vibe here. Like, I am living vicariously through them, especially this line right here that Jay-Z had, you know, cock back, snap back, see my cut through the holes. I don't know what that part means, but, you know, get my swagger back, popping bottles, putting supermodels in the cab, all that kind of shit. Like, yeah, arm out the window, through the city, I maneuver slow, shit like that. I'm totally, yeah, I'm living vicariously through them right now with this track. Definitely doing it. All right, let's keep going.
And all the ladies in the house got them showing out. I'm done, I hit you up, man. Nah. Welcome to Havana. Smoking Cubanos with Castro and Cabanas. Viva Mexico. Cubano, Dominicano, all the plugs that I know.
Lord, please let them accept the things they can't change. And pray that all of their pain be champagne.
Oh my God, man. All right, we're just gonna drop into track 5. Gotta Have It.
Louder.
Produced by the Neptunes. God, that sounds familiar. The Neptunes. Great beat so far, man.
Hello, 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 white America, assassinate my character. Money matrimony, yeah, they tryna break the marriage up. Who gon' act phony, or who gon' try to embarrass ya? I'ma need a day off, I think I called Ferris up.
Mueller had a Mueller, but I switched it for a Miele, cause I'm richer. And prior to this shit was moving freebase.
Had a conference with the DJs. Yeah.
This little 3 days. Synthetic bass beast is fucking awesome. Replay. Jesus, man, this shit's great. I want to go back real quick and talk about a couple of lyrics on Otis real quick. What was it? I made Yeezus, so I'm never going to hell. That was great. Anyway. Oh, Lord, please let them accept the things they can't change and pray that all their pain be champagne. I like that quite a bit. You know, with this one, that synthetic beat, that whatever, that shit was fucking awesome. And then what's interesting is there's that higher pitched vocal loop. I assume it's a sample going in the background. And I feel like I'm hearing that. My brain's going, this should be bothering me. This should be bothering me, but it fits in. And so I'm not necessarily struggling with that sound, but I hear it. And there's this weird event happening in my mind like, oh, it's almost like if I notice it, I start to dislike it, but that doesn't make any sense, you know, because I'm noticing all of the sound. Anyway, there you go. Let's keep going. Cause this is just like, again, this is a great, this is fucking great. I can see why people are into this. That synthetic beat is so cool. Nice, nice, man. I think with that vocal loop, it's because it's working with the beat so well. It's really synced in. It's almost like the beat itself. It's like the backbone of it. Yeah, that was cool, man. This is great. I'm really enjoying this. You know, another thing that I like about this is I mentioned a lot on the Unlocked album, Denzel Curry and Kenny Beats, right? Like, I just enjoyed that so much because I felt like they were having fun. And I love that. I know I get critical about lyrics, and I love these raw emotions and deep stories and stuff that's meaningful because it's just powerful music. But it's also important to have fun. You know, you can't just take shit seriously all the time because you'll destroy yourself, essentially. If anything, you'll just grind yourself down into like a little stub of nothing, right? So it's cool because so far we're 5 tracks in, and the production level is top notch. You can tell they put in the effort, but with the lyrics, you can tell they're having fun. And so I can just picture Jay-Z and Kanye working together, writing these lines and fucking like laughing at each other's lines and, you know, just having a good time while then also being extremely serious and putting the work in with the production and the beats and all that shit. So it's a great blend. Great blend. So far, what if it takes a terrible, terrible turn? I don't think that it will, but it's fun to, what's it called? Suspense, drama. Track 6 is called New Day. It's produced by Kanye. RZA. Oh, nice. RZA and Mike Dean again. This will be interesting. Kanye and RZA. Cool. Track 6. It already kind of has that. Oh, Nina Simone sample too.
And I'll never let my son have an ego. You'll be nice to everyone wherever we go. I mean, I might even make him be Republican. To everybody know he love white people. And I'll never let him leave his college girlfriend. And get caught up with the groupies in the whirlwind. And I'll never let him ever hit the telethon. I mean, even the people dying in the world ends. And I never let his mom move to L.A.
Oh, fuck,
and when
yeah.
she couldn't take the pressure, now we all pray.
I'm liking this one quite a bit, quite a bit. A good turn too on the album, just because it's been fun and light. Fucking. This is a great, great song. Hell yeah. I don't want to pause it because it sounds fantastic. And I'm getting swept up. I don't know if you noticed. I've tried to say like two or three different things and then I shut up and listen because I'm being swept up in the song. A little early, but this is probably going to be my favorite track because it's hitting all the notes for me, right? Good, cool beat, you know. And I was going to say at the very beginning, RZA, you could kind of get that, just that taste of RZA with the beat, you know, just that structure. Nina Simone being sampled, putting the auto-tune over her voice is great. And then these lyrics about Kanye talking about his dad or his son. You know, he doesn't want his son to have to go through the shit. I'll never let him hit the telethon. Oh, God. I will never forget that Katrina telethon with him and Mike Myers. George Bush does not care about black people. Oh, my God. Amazing. I just want him to have an easy life, not the Yeezy life. I want him to be someone people like. I'll never let him hit the strip club. There's not a place to find love. And I'll never let his mom move to LA. That's a tough one. That's a tough one right there. Knowing she couldn't take the pressure, now we all pray. You know, I like this for all the obvious reasons, but really... When I was talking about Pinocchio's story and that Kanye died and now it's a new Kanye who's letting himself be swallowed up by, you know, the lifestyle or the industry, what have you. It's cool to every now see just a glimmer, you know? And it, honestly, I'm kind of torn though, because the idea that that person is still there, it creates this longing for me to say, I want that person to come back, but he can't. He can't. So it just makes it kind of hard sometimes. I want to actually, this might kill the vibe, might kill the flow, but I want to tell a story about a friend I had in high school who was, you know, was a big party dude, and him and I would go dirt biking all the time, and he was just crazy. He was fucking crazy. He'd go do all these crazy jumps and shit, and there was one time he tried to do this jump, and he broke his arm, and then they put the cast on him and the metal bar. They told him he can't ride for, you know, 3 months. He said, fuck that. Four weeks later, something like that. Back on the bike, goes to hit the same jump again to try and clear it. Falls again, breaks his arm at the end of the bar that they put in. So they had to take out the old bar. It bent and shit. It was nasty. Put a new one in. Anyway, I remember having a conversation with him, and he was big in the, you know, he was party and wild motocross life and pot all the time and metal and all this other shit. And there was one time, just one time, he was talking about how, you know, everyone sees me as this crazy dude and, you know, devil music and party. And he's like, but I'm not necessarily that. I just do that because that's what people expect from me. And every now and then I kind of like not want to be that, you know? And it was just, it was really weird. It was surprising, especially at that young age, because we were teenagers, and it blew me away, honestly. It blew me away that there was this other person deep, deep, deep down inside that had completely different desires from life, different wishes in terms of like the type of friends that he hung out with, how they treated him, what they expected from him, all this stuff. It was, I still remember it vividly, vividly, that conversation. Get a little stirred up. But this reminds me of that too. You know, there's just it's interesting, and you never know sometimes with people how they are in public and how they act and how we perceive them. But then sometimes you find out, if you ever get that rare chance, sometimes you're lucky to find out, wow, there's somebody else completely different buried inside. And it makes me sad to think that there are people buried inside themselves. Anyway, let's keep going before I start just crying for no reason whatsoever.
Yeah. Sorry, Junior. I already ruined you because you ain't even alive.
This is a great fucking jam.
Sins of a father make your life 10 times harder. I just want to take you to a barber. Bonding on charters, all the shit that I never did. Teach you good values so you cherish it. Promise to never leave him, even if his mama tweaking, because my dad left me, and I promise never repeat him. Never repeat him. Never repeat him.
This is great. This is fucking great. Yeah, and that drops in too, man. Kind of bittersweet, you know? It's like a victory.
It's a new life for me. Drifting on by.
Yeah.
Drifting on. It's a new life for me, yeah. It's a new life for me. Ooh. And I'm feeling birds flying high, you know how I feel.
Oh. Oh, interesting. Huh. I wonder if that, like, it's supposed to mark different little chapters or something. I don't know. Well, I'm glad that came in, because I was like really tearing up at the end, because being a father, anyway, beautiful song. That's going to be my favorite from the album. I can tell already. If I start talking about it, I'll start crying, but beautiful song. Really, 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 really like that song. Track 7 is called That's My Bitch. Jeff Basker, Kanye, and Q-Tip. And yeah, here we go. Oh, cool.
Hello, can I speak to yeah, you know who you are. Look, you had no idea what you're dealing with. Something on something's real as shit. Pop champagne, I give you a sip. About to go dumb, how come? Yeah, that's my bitch. That's my bitch. Shorty right there, that's my bitch. That's my bitch.
I'm going to pause right here before it drops in. I want to say one thing. There's a Prodigy song called Smack My Bitch Up. Great song. And people were all offended when it came out. And I learned that, I guess, when you, in the UK, that's where the Prodigy was from, the phrase smack my bitch up meant go do your thing. Now, I say that to put that kind of context into this song before we get into it. And then I also want to mention, you know, with Dark Twisted Fantasy, there was a lot of people saying he's not talking about women, he's talking about the industry. Now, I think this track might relate to all three. You know, he's talking about women probably here. I want to say it before I hear the rest of the lyrics. I just want to have this context out here. Okay, that's my bitch. You know, that's my girl. That's my thing. I'm going to go do my thing. You know, I'm going to drink some champagne. I'm about to go dumb. That's my thing. And then also the relation to the lifestyle, not necessarily the industry, but the lifestyle. So there's these three elements that are all feeding together in my brain right now to listen to this track.
I'm a freak, huh? Rock star life. The second girl with us, that's our wife. Hey, boys and girls, I got a new riddle. Who's a new old perm that's trying to play second fiddle? Don't disrespect, I'm not trying to be little. With my dick worth money, I put money in the middle. When she
this is a great song too, man. Great song.
Picasso was alive, he would have made her. That's right, nigga, Mona Lisa can't fade her. I mean, Marilyn Monroe, she's quite nice. But why all the pretty icons always all white? Got some color girls in the MoMA. Half these bras ain't got nothing on Malone. Don't make me bring Thelma in it. Bring Helly, bring Penelope and Selma in it. You belong with niggas who used to be known for dope dealing. You too dope for any of your fellow civilians. Now shoot her, just stop looking at her tits. Get your own dog, get her. That's my bitch.
Oh, man. I'm going to let it wrap up and we'll talk about lyrics. I paused it right before it drops in. It looks like it's going to drop right in. So, but I just want to talk about the lyrics a little bit. Great beat. I love that. It's almost like a tribal drum beat that was going on. And this is cool. Him listing off all these chicks: Halle Berry, Penelope Cruz, Selma Hayek. You deserve three stacks. Word to Andre. That's got to be Andre 3000, right? But I don't know. Three stacks, businessman. Maybe it's just like a quick shout out. Andre has been showing love to black girls in his music since 94. Even use Beyonce as an example of a beautiful black woman. Oh, okay. Okay, cool. Cool. So that makes sense. Some of these other people, Larry Gagosian. Anyway, you belong with these people who used to be known for dope dealing. You're too dope for any of those civilians. Good line. God, man. You know, I feel like this is a great party album. You just throw it on and just let it roll. You know, the production is so good. The lyrics are great. The beats are great. Everything's just going, man. I mean, I love New Day. I love New Day. I'm glad I'm hearing this album when I get to my 1 year anniversary, which is coming up pretty soon. I'm going to do my favorite top 10 tracks, which is going to be incredibly difficult. I've already started the list and it's going to be incredibly difficult, but that one might, that one has a fighting chance. Cause that's a great, great track. Okay, let's move on to track 8, which is Welcome to the Jungle, which is also a Guns N' Roses track. So I'm curious to see if there's any relevance there, but that'll be kind of neat. Produced by Swizz Beat. I don't know who that is. Track 8, Welcome to the Jungle.
Yeah. Welcome to the jungle. Welcome to the jungle. Well,
yeah. Now that almost sounds like Kendrick.
I asked her where she wanna be when she's 25. She turned around and looked at me and she said alive.
Welcome to the jungle. Welcome to the jungle. Well,
Black axle rolls, move halves and rolls. Come down to the jungle, just ask for hoes. Move blocks and squares, move apples and pears. Work pots and pans, just to cop me some airs. My uncle died, my daddy did too. Paralyzed by the pain, I could barely move. My nephew gone, my heart is torn. Sometimes I look to the sky, ask why I was born. My faith in God, every day is hard. Every night is worse, that's why I pray so hard.
Why I pray so hard? This is crazy, God. Just when I thought I had everything, I lost it all. So case arrive, get a case arrive. Let it taste the pain before it goes too far.
I'm pausing the middle of the verse, but I want to make sure this is about Tupac. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry. I'm kind of having a hard time with this track because I really like it. I'm liking the lyrics. I'm liking the tone, especially when that piano came in. That was really cool. But this beat, this da 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 da, it's a little, right now on my first listen, just on the first listen, it's a little too prominent, a little too dominating on the track overall. Like when the other sounds started coming in with the piano and stuff, I liked that more. Especially the tone of the piano is kind of going with the lyrics here, matching the tone of the lyrics. You know, sometimes I look to the sky and ask why I was born. My faith in God, every day is hard. Every night is worse. That's why I pray so hard. You know, my uncle died. My daddy did too. So, but that prominent beat, it's extremely repetitive. So, but we'll see. We'll keep going. We'll see how I feel. And then with additional listens too, it'll be interesting.
I'm losing myself. I'm stuck in the moment. I look in the mirror, my only opponent.
Nice.
Where the fuck is the press? Where the fuck is the press? Either they know or don't care. I'm fucking.
getting depressed, no crying in public.
That piano hit is great.
I'm already dying, so fuck it, well.
Welcome to the jungle, welcome to the jungle, well.
God damn it, damn it.
It's very prominent, very distinct. It isn't bad, but I like that more with the piano, the guitar in there. I think that's guitar. What, you know, that beat, that da, 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 da. I wonder, I don't know anything about Morse code, but I wonder if it mimics the SOS signal from Morse code, or if that's the idea behind it. That's really kind of the impression I'm getting, like, especially with these lyrics where he's talking, you know, he's just talking about being stressed out, basically, you know, I'm champagne for the pain, weed for the low, I'm losing myself, I'm stuck in the moment, I look in the mirror, my only opponent, which is a great, great line. But I wonder if that beat that I'm kind of struggling with is supposed to mimic, like, a Morse code signal for SOS, like, we need help, something's wrong, we need help, you know? That was a cool jam. I mean, it was cool. I'm curious to see how I feel about it with additional listens. So we'll keep going here. The next track is Who Gonna Stop Me? Produced by Kanye West and Zach Paisley. Paisley. I butchered the shit out of that, didn't I? All right, track 9. Who's Gonna Stop Me? Cool. Nice.
Millions of our people lost. Bow heads and pray to the Lord. Till I die, I'm a fucking bar. Who gon' stop me?
This is cool. I wonder if this is something left over from Yeezus. It feels like this would be something that came off of Yeezus.
Who gon' stop me? No brakes, I need State Farm. So many watches, I need 8 arms. One neck, but got 8 charms. Who gon' stop me, huh? Niggas talking, they bitch made. Ixnay off my dick's nay. That's pig Latin, it's bae. Who gon' stop me, huh? God. Last night, it goes so well. Got kicked up at the hotel. Got a little freaky like Marvin Albert. Yes, tell how a co-sale. Just something like the Holocaust.
God, this portion right here, that distorted, I guess not really distorted, but just heavy synthetic sound is cool. Cool.
Strap, you know what that's for. Yeah, we purple, my money purple. Y'all Steve purple, I'm open, so yeah, person, who gonna stop me, huh?
Oh my God. You know, one thing I'm not really liking, especially on the chorus, or maybe it's, yeah, it is the chorus, that sample of I Can't Stop, you know, it's moving around. And I feel like I can understand what they were going for. It's just not really jiving with me that much. I find it to be a little distracting from this awesome synthetic sound that's coming in with that chorus, that beat, man. It's fucking awesome. Fucking Kanye. Kanye's got great lyrics, man. He's just got entertaining, funny lines, man. Heard Yeezy was racist. Well, I guess that's on one basis. I only like green faces. She fucked the doorman. That's cool. I fucked the waitress. Good shit. And then this whole pig Latin portion is pretty funny. This is something like the Holocaust. Millions of our people lost. Yeah. And that's just got to be comparing. Yeah. Yeah. Condition of black people. Yeah. Yo, weed purple, my money purple. You Steve Urkel, I'm in Oprah Circle. Unlike Amber Rose's new... Okay. All right, let's keep going here. I clipped in the beginning of Jay-Z's verse, which is, that's a no-no, but I, you know, that's how it goes sometimes.
I'm winning again, I'm at the win, I'm at the table, I'm gambling. Lucky lefty, I expect a seven.
Oh yeah, cool.
I went through hell, I'm expecting yeah. Heaven, I'm old, cause I'm dull, and I stuck to the Chico. I'm here, oh yeah.
Hell yeah.
I promise I ain't going nowhere. Okay, here, like a hare, like a rabbit, I like carrots. I'm allergic to having bunny ears, like broke, like nope, like huh, I ain't no joke. I can't be stopped, like nope, like nope. Still a beat, no.
Two cool. seats in the 911. No limit on
Very
the black
fucking
car.
Cool.
Told y'all I was gonna go ham to the ocean with my backyard. No lies in my verses. Hey, please put all the curses. Hey, shit gotta come in some way. Fuck, when you're growing up worthless. Street smart and I'm book smart. Could have been a chemist cause I cook smart. Only thing to stop me is me. Hey, and I'ma stop when the hook stop. Hold up.
Hell yeah.
This is something like the Holocaust.
That was great. That was great.
Millions of our people lost.
Hell yeah. Now, if it drops into the next one, I know I'm killing the flow. I loved how that track closed out. You know, I was unsure if I was going to put a heart next to it because of the echoey I can't stop. You know, that's kind of throwing me off. But as soon as it dumped out and it just dropped into that incredible synthetic sound, man. And then with the keyboard that was bouncing around, that was awesome. And then Jay's verse here is really good too. I told you I was going to go ham so the ocean was my backyard. No lies in my verses. Please pardon all the curses. Shit got to come in some way when you grow up worthless. Hell yeah. Middle finger to my old life. Special shout out to my old head. If it wasn't for your advice, I would have been so dead. This is great. Great verse. Graduated to the MoMA. I did all of this without a diploma. Graduated from the Cormor. You can play me for the motherfucking fool if you wanna. Yeah, that's great. Dude, that was such a killer closer for the second half of the song. That was awesome. That was great. All right. Track 10 is called Murder to Excellence, produced by S1 and Swiss Beats again. I'm kind of curious to see what Swiss Beats does, or Swizz Beats does, because the Welcome to the Jungle, that very distinct, you know, I do feel like maybe it was supposed to be like an SOS signal or Morse code or something like that. But I'm kind of curious to see what he does on this one just to see how much different it is. All right, track 10, Murder to Excellence.
Bloody murder, 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 bloody murder, 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 murder. Bloody murder.
Like a distorted guitar strum. Yeah, that sounds like a guitar just distorted as shit.
Papery murder, black on black murder. Papery murder, black on black murder.
This is to the memory of Dan Roy Henry. Too much enemy fire to catch a friend. Grades from the same shade, nigga, we on the same team. Giving you respect, I expect the same thing.
And I could die any day type attitude. Plus his little brother got shot repping his avenue. It's time for us to stop and redefine black power. 41 souls murdered in 50 hours.
I like this. Especially, you know, no shop class, but half the school's got a tool. That's good. That's really good. And then I didn't even know about this Dan Roy Henry. Killed in a police shooting. Controversially, the officer was later given Officer of the Year award. Fuck, man. And then, you know, black on black murder and stuff like that. Yeah. 41 souls murdered in 50 hours. March 31st. 41 people were shot in Chicago. Only four of them died, but still, the fact that they're getting shot. Yeah. This is something I cannot wrap my head around. I just can't. And the thing is I'm so far removed. I mean, that environment, those neighborhoods, that lifestyle, gangs and all that stuff, man, it's just a completely different planet for me, completely different planet. And on one hand, I feel compelled to comment on it. But on the other hand, it feels so out of place for me to do so. You know, I might as well make a detailed comment about professional tennis because I know shit about tennis, you know, like it just doesn't make sense for me to talk about it because I don't have anything of value to add because it's all just outside perception bullshit. I have no idea the reality. I have no idea the reality, but I don't like it. I mean, if I'm going to say anything, that's really what it comes down to. And I know that's just a stupid, simple, kind of like a pointless thing to say, but you know, if there was a way to stop it, I wish it would stop. I don't know how you stop it. I don't know. I mean, it's just this crazy, vicious cycle of low income, no jobs, no way out. Selling drugs is easier. So now you're fighting for territory. You know, it's just a constant cycle. Anyway, all right, let's keep going.
If you put crabs in a barrel to ensure your survival, you gon' end up pulling down niggas that look just like you. What up, blood? What up, cuz? It's all black. I love us.
The papery murder. Black on black murder. The papery murder. Black on black murder again. Black on black murder.
I'm gonna pause it here because it looks like it's gonna drop into a second part. You know, I wonder what with somebody like Kanye and Jay-Z and anybody involved with making this project, or anybody who's, you know, prominent in the hip hop scene in general, I wonder if they feel the same way I do. Like, I wonder if it's even worse. You know, Kendrick Lamar really, really hammered on this in To Pimp a Butterfly, that survivor's guilt and shit like that, and his those three friends dying when he was on tour, and, you know, you couldn't be there, you couldn't stop it, you FaceTimed him instead of going to the hospital and all that shit. I have to believe it's even harder for them, because you've got this weird element of getting out and making it, and okay, finally all that shit's behind me. But just because it's behind you doesn't mean it's gone. You know, it's just gone for you, that individual that got out. And then now it's like, okay, you're this, you know, prominent figure in media, you've got all this money, you have influence, you have the ability to make a change, but then you probably still feel the same way I do. Like, how do I change it? Like, I feel helpless to begin with just because of my own situation. But it would be weird to have a place of, you know, I've got media influence, I've got money, I've got resources, right? I feel like I have the tools to make change, but then you still look at the situation of, you know, rampant gang lifestyle in that kind of neighborhood, and, you know, even when you have resources, you can't change it. And then to see, you know, yeah, black people killing black people and being black and watching that happen, it's just got to fucking tear your heart out. Especially too, when you come from a position of, okay, you feel like the country you're living in is racist. You know, there's so many instances of cops just being awful towards black people, awful, killing black people in the worst fucking ways too. And so it's just on all sides, you know, like here I have the resource, like I got out, great, it's behind me, but it's not behind me. I don't want to see my people killing each other. I've got the resources. I feel compelled to do something about it, but I can't change it. My country doesn't give a fuck. You know, the people running the country, like, that's just, it's just got to feel like this weird box. And then yet somehow, you know, you're supposed to celebrate because you got out. That's got to just linger in the back of the mind constantly, man, constantly. Huh. This is a great track because I've never considered this perspective before. So this is very revealing to me, and I appreciate it.
Domino, domino, only spot a few blacks the higher I go. What's up, well, shout out the O. That ain't enough, we gonna need a million more. Kicking the dough, Biggie flow. I'm all dressed up with nowhere to go.
Yeah, it's all messed up when it's nowhere to go. So we won't take the time out till we reach the T.O.P. For parolees, the whole G's, so keys, low keys. We like the promised land of the OGs in the past. If you picture events like a black tie, what's the last thing you expect to see? Black guys. What's the life expect to see? Black guys. The system's working effectively. That's why Sunday morning, praise the Lord, you the girl that Jesus has been saving me for. So let's savor this moment and take it to the floor. Black excellence, truly yours.
Cool jam, cool jam. I was gonna talk about this end here. Where was it, talking about the higher I go? only spot a few blacks the higher I go. What's up to Will? It's got to be Will Smith, I assume. And then O has got to be Oprah Winfrey. Yeah, Will Smith. Oprah, yeah, okay. That ain't enough. We're going to need a million more. Kick in the door, Biggie Flow. Biggie. I got to do Life After Death. I'm all dressed up with nowhere to go. So that line right there reminded me of the interview I was watching with Tupac, and how he was talking about, okay, he makes it, and now he feels completely displaced because he has all this money, so he can't go back and live in the hood, right? He'll just get fucking robbed all the time. But then he can't go live in the nice white neighborhoods because they don't want him. It's just, and when he said that, there were so many things that Tupac said that just, oh my God, man, I was so wrong about Tupac in so many ways. And that was such a great experience for me to just be wrong and be shown how wrong I was. But I never even considered that. Like, yeah, you make money and you always just think, oh yeah, you just go move to the rich neighborhood where they don't want you because you're a black rapper with fucking tattoos and all this shit. Like, yeah, you're just displaced. Like, you're almost homeless in a sense. Yeah, interesting. Cool song, man. Very cool song. I won't harp on it. I said my piece earlier. I think that's really all there is to say. To say more, you know. But good song. Good song. Good song. I really don't have that much to say. I was just going to repeat what I'd already said. So that don't think like I'm trying to hold anything back. I was just going to repeat myself. So I don't need to do that. Track 11 is called Made in America, featuring Frank Ocean, produced by the guy's name I butchered earlier. I'm not going to say it again because I'll fuck it up again. Here we go. Track 11 is called Made in America.
And I'll bring you out the darkness. Sweet King Martin. Sweet Queen Coretta.
Wow.
Sweet Brother Malcolm. Sweet Queen Betty.
This is like
Mother Mary.
Like almost like super spacey 80s style sound right here.
Sweet Jesus. We made it in America. I told my mama I was on the come up. She said you going to school, I give you a summer. Then she met no ID and gave me his number. 10 years later, she driving a Hummer. Niggas hustle every day for a beat from Ye. What I do, turn around, get them beats to Jay. And I'm rapping on the beats they was supposed to buy. I guess I'm getting high on my own supply. Downtown mixing fabrics, trying to find
this
the magic.
This is cool sound.
Started a little blog just to get some traffic.
This is cool. You know, this whole verse is neat after having seen the Genius documentary and understanding more about where he came from and when in his early days and making beats and trying to get his own album and he just couldn't quite get there and his mom wanting him to go to school and all this shit. So this is pretty cool. Pretty cool. I guess I'm getting high off my own supply. I like that. I'm ramping on the beats they were supposed to buy. I'm getting high off my own supply. And this was a cool little play on words here too. Start a little blog just to get some traffic. Old folks tell you not to play in traffic. A million hits and the web crashes because he's getting too much web traffic. So that's kind of neat.
Sweet Brother Malcolm. Sweet Queen.
I love this just real spacey, floaty, synthetic, I guess, keyboard. But it's so
Sweet
washed
Jesus.
Out, you know?
We made it in America.
And then the piano comes in. It's so great with the piano dropping in like that.
Oh, sweet baby Jesus. We made it in America.
On my daughter, so I'm boiling this water. The scales was lopsided. I'm just restoring order. Hold up, here comes grandma. What's up, yaya? What's that smell? Oh, I'm just boiling some agua. No papa, bad Santa. The streets raised me, brought in my bad manners.
So this portion here he must be talking about, because I don't know much about Jay-Z's past. I don't know if there's documentaries or anything like that. They're probably not. He's probably smart enough to go, no, we're not going to talk about all the times I sold drugs. But this is kind of crazy. Like if he's living with his grandma and basically cooking up drugs in his fucking grandma's house and she's waking up, you know, shh, don't wake up grandma. Huh. The scales was lopsided. I was just restoring order. So I think that's a play on words with, you know, weighing out drugs to get paid. Yeah. Yeah. That's a good line right there. What's that smell? I'm just boiling some water. No papa, bad Santa. The streets mazed me. Pardon my manners. Got my liberty chopping grams up. Street justice. I pray God understands us. Yeah, that's a great line right there too, because especially if you have any religious beliefs and, you know, the idea of sin and doing wrong and all this other stuff, and it's like, you know what, I gotta fucking survive. So hopefully Hopefully God understands I'm breaking the rules for a good reason, you know? Good stuff, man. Good stuff. Hey, you guys, I don't know if you noticed, but this album, this Watch the Throne album, pretty fucking good. Yeah, pretty good. Yeah, you guys should check it out sometime. Sweet Queen Coretta. And then this part with Frank Ocean's cool because it's harkening back to the different leaders that have existed and making it in America, you know? Like, yeah, what would Martin Luther King or Malcolm X or all these guys, I assume that's for Malcolm X. What they would think about seeing black artists being so popular and famous and with so much wealth and stuff. Cool.
Sweet baby Jesus.
Okay. I was wondering if the piano was going to drop in again. Yeah, that was great. That was a good jam too. Good jam. This is a fucking great album, man. I know I was saying it earlier, but they've put the work in to make great music, great production so far. I have been a little surprised though lately. Like, maybe it's just the way they arranged the track order, but you know, it seems like they put a lot of the heavy production up front to kind of pull you in, which makes sense. Makes perfect sense, right? Grab them. And then now that we're kind of easing into it, the productions has backed off just a tad, not a lot, not like it's bad or anything, but just, you know, it's not as just produced like crazy as these first couple tracks were. Oh shit, I lost my tab. Let's see, Murder to Excellence, Made in America. Track 12 is called Why I Love You, featuring Mr. Hudson, produced by Mike Dean and Kanye West. Looking forward to some more guitar here, folks. Track 12, all right, track 12, Why I Love You. Oh yeah. Oh, yeah. Hell yeah. I mean, right there. That gets a heart right there.
Same people that I fought for, that I fight for, that I ride for, that I live for, that I die for. Be the reason that these niggas is alive for, and they want me dead. I'm sorry, but I just can't die for you. But I can make them put their hands in the sky for you. We wait for the fireworks like July 4. Get fly more, get high more. Cry more, why for? Fuck you squares. The circle got smaller, the castle got bigger, the walls got taller. And
truth be told, after all that said,
niggas still got love for you.
Nice. God, this chorus is fucking amazing. This, Yeah. Great. This final portion of the verse, man. Fuck you squares. The circle got smaller. The castle got bigger. The walls got taller. And truth be told, after all that said, still got love for you. That's great. Great. Great little section right there. When the love is gone till blood is drawn, we're no longer wearing the same uniform. And then, you know, I tried to teach to be kings. All they ever wanted to be was soldiers. What was cool here too, in this portion up here, he crossed, I think it's called cross the bar line, but I don't think that's actually accurate for what he did because he changed the rhyming scheme up and I liked how he did it. Same people I fought for, fight for, ride for, live for, die for, all the reason they're alive. They want me dead, but I'm sorry, I just can't die for you. And then, yeah, he gets out of the four and drops into the you, but then he gets back to the July 4th and, you know, cry bore, why four. So cool little rhyming structure in there. That was well done. Well done. Good job, Jay-Z. Well done. Oh my God. The sound on this is fucking phenomenal. Phenomenal. And I know I clipped. Let me back this up just a tiny bit because I did clip Jay-Z's entrance here on the verse. And I know that's not how you're supposed to do it. Although, one thing I've noticed with Tidal, it doesn't work quite as well moving stuff around as Spotify does.
Show love to you niggas, you ripped out my heart and you stepped on it. I picked up the pieces where you swept on it.
Yeah.
Damn, this shit needs a mess, don't it? Shit feeling like death, don't it? Charge it to the game, whatever's left on it. I spent about a minute, maybe less on it. Fly Pelican, fly, turn the jets on it. But first I shall digress on it. Was not good king, maybe too much of a good thing, huh? Got body armor, a nigga gotta watch the throne.
And I'm busting back. Some niggas in the glass, I should not throw stones.
Yeah,
what do you
nice.
Do when the love turn to hate?
Gotta separate from these fucking fakes.
Caesar didn't see it, so he ceased to assist. So the nigga that killed him had keys to his shit. Am I my brother's keeper?
Only if that nigga don't creep up.
Got a pistol under my pillow.
I never been a deep sleeper.
That was awesome. So if it weren't for New Day, that would be my favorite track. That's a great track. That's a really, really, really good track. Man, the way it just fucking drops in with that chorus, so much sound. It's great. And these verses are really fucking good, man. Really, really good. I'm bulletproof. You can't get nothing past me. Got body armor. Am I my brother's keeper? Only if he doesn't creep up. Oh, man. Good lines. Good lines in here. I like this too. You ripped out my heart and you stepped on it. I picked up the pieces before you swept on it. I like that a lot. A lot. So he's saying, you know, I'm over it before you can even do anything else. Before you can't even put me away. I'm already over it. He just picked up the pieces and charged to the game whatever's left on it. I spent about a minute, maybe less on it. Fly a pelican, fly and turn the jets on it. But first I shall digress on it. I like that too. Jay-Z's great. I mean, I believe it. I'm not trying to say it is not true, but it is difficult to believe that he doesn't write this shit down beforehand. That's fucking crazy to me. That's crazy to me. I got to do more Jay-Z. What sucks is YouTube blocked it. Hopefully YouTube doesn't block this one. That was a great track. Great track. All right. We're going to move on. Track 13 is called Illest Motherfucker Alive with Southside, produced by Southside Mike Dean and Kanye Sweet. I love it. Anytime I see Mike Dean listed there, I'm very happy. Track 13, Illest Motherfucker Alive. With the circus sound again. Okay. So there's no silence. Thanks for the warning. Even Genius has it. Listen here.
White Lamborghini Countach, two of them.
God, some of these synthetic sounds they dump in here are incredible. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Damn, baby, pussy can't be your only hustle. Unless you bad as Naomi Russell. Bulletproof condom when I'm in these hoes. Got staples on my dick. Why? Fucking centerfolds. And I swear to God, they so cold. Got a nigga in Miami wearing winter clothes.
Oh,
I got my fur on, feeling like Jerome. She got a fur too, we get eyes in her rolls. Line by $1,000 tee with no logos.
Let that me part
see
is great.
What I see when my eyes close.
This fucking line, I almost didn't get it. Got staples on my dick, why fucking centerfold? But I mean, there was just like a half a second where I was like, what? Because at first I thought he was talking about like stapling his dick closed, you know, so he can't get anybody pregnant, which I think is probably part of the intention of the line. But then just the idea of a centerfold and very well done. Very well done. Very clever. So I wonder, though, too, you know, he's talking about, the staples holding it together, but I also wonder if it's kind of a joke about he's gonna, you know, never ever get somebody knocked up, so he'll put staples on his dick to keep it closed. But it's such a great line. Such a great line. Not a whole lot. I mean, he's talking about girls and, you know, wanting them, they just want money and all that kind of shit. This line was interesting, though. Too close, you comatose, so dope you overdose. And maybe, I don't know, at the time it struck me as a little bit more interesting there. There was something, I felt like there was another layer to this. So dope you overdose. Anyway, I won't get too hung up on that. Let's drop into the chorus.
Take it how you want to a nigga dead. Till then, I'm the illest motherfucker alive.
Just over the top production here. This is crazy. Yeah. He's got like a choir of vocals almost. Piano, synthetic beats, this echoey beat.
Fuck your walls like Eddie Murphy's couch. The rock is in the building. We should have stayed in the house. I don't even know what we doing here. Seems to be a complete waste of gear. Just
I need a slow motion video right now.
Kid Cudi's in this part?
Cause I'm a winner.
Ah, cool. Cool. That was cool. That was a great song. This whole album is fucking fantastic so far. I want to go back. My house is like a museum, so I see him when I'm peeing. That shit was fucking great. I like that a lot. And then I think this is a reference to the movie Heat. No one will leave when the heat is coming. I learned that. This is where De Niro would be if he ain't turned back. It's been so long since I've seen that movie, though, so I don't... It's got to be toward the end, right? Master Criminal. Yeah. Okay, anyway. And then, what's his name? I love this. Fuck your awards like Eddie Murphy's couch. Great line. And then, so what? Did he get snubbed at the awards or something? Oh, man. I don't even know what we're doing here. It seems to be a complete waste of gear. Just a fucking waste of time. A complete waste of bottles. Fashion is weak. They'd be wasting all the models. He boycotted the show in 99. Okay. Oh, too many rap artists are being overlooked. Oh, okay. Interesting. All right. Cool song, man. Great song. God, these guys are killing it. Just killing it. Let's see here. Moving into track 14, which is Ham, produced by Kanye West and Lex Luger. I feel like I've heard that name before. So let's jump in. Let me back this up a little bit. I've always wondered what that meant. I don't know if Ham meets something else and he's putting a new meaning to it, or if that's what it's always meant. I've never known what it meant. But oh my God, dude, when that shit hits, boom, that shit hits. Some of these lines are pretty fucking good. Again, like Eli, this got to be when he beat Tom Brady. Oh no, okay. I don't know Eli Porter. Anyway. I was hoping that's what it was. That would have been funny. 2011, I don't remember when the Patriots beat the Giants beat the Patriots. But no one expected that shit to happen. It Watch the Throne, and when Watch the Throne drops, they kill themselves. All right, let's keep going. That was cool, man. Goddamn, there's a lot of sound. A lot of sound coming at Jay's verse at the end. You know, at first, I was laughing at it because these are good lines, right? You know, great whites and vultures and all this other stuff. But then he drops in about his uncle. Or no, I'm sorry. When my nephew died, daddy did. Jay-Z's nephew, Khalik, was killed in a car crash with a drunk driver in the car that Jay bought for him. Oh, fuck, man. Wow. He also refers to the passing of his own father, whom he hardly knew. That's crazy. Took the price on my uncle's head. Nobody called the cops as my uncle bled, so I feel like I would like to know my uncle's bread. Jay suspects someone put a hit out on his uncle because he says the killer took the price on his head. Huh. Well, that's what the annotation says. I don't know if that's what Jay-Z actually thinks, but yeah, it was a trippy verse because it's talking about, you know, all the stuff he's been through and all this other stuff, and then it just drops into this really solid, like, real shit right here. Headshots, fuck your vest, fuck the pigs, no pork on my fork. Yeah, good shit. All right, track 15 is going to be called Primetime, produced by No ID. I don't think I'm too familiar with him. I don't know if I've heard him before. Here we go, track 15, Primetime.
Cool. In the time of our lives, baby.
Baby.
Turn the music up. Primetime.
Baby. Baby.
Oh, yeah.
Baby.
Yeah.
Prime time, beat by Dion. Our third eon, that's what the fuck we on. More money, 40-year-old phenom. My 15 minutes of fame and stretch beyond. I hit the club, order some Grey Goose. Switched it for Ciroc to get Puff Stop the boost. New money, I found the fountain of youth. I'm headed to Miami to fuck up the fountain blue.
Night is young, what
baby,
the fuck you wanna do?
This is a cool track, man.
Baby,
great beat.
Baby, night is young, what baby, the fuck you gonna do, huh?
I wanna go back to these lines. I wanna spend a little bit of time on this. Not a lot. I won't get crazy. Because I like what he's doing with all these numbers, right? So more money. 40-year-old phenom. My 15 minutes prevents a shame. Stress to be, you know. Well, okay, I can't read apparently. At 42, better than 24s. I carried the 4-5, mastered 48 laws. I don't know what 48 laws are. The 4-5 has got to be a pistol, right? I carried the 4-5, so a 45 caliber. 42, better than 24s. Maybe he's talking about rims? I don't know. Let's click the annotation and see what they say here. Oh, better than 24-year-old rappers. Cough, Drake, cough. Okay, sure. All right. Still wearing my 23s. They can't fuck with the boy. Far as them 16s, I'm 23 of it all. I don't know any of that. Oh, okay. When it comes to verses composed of 16 bars, Jay's the Michael Jordan. Okay. Okay. That makes sense. Riding that 6 deuce, that 911, which I believe is a Porsche. I only subtract the roof. So he's talking about take the roof off of his car, which is kind of cool. Huh. All right. Well, let's keep going.
Basking in the lime, cash is in its prime, culling out of the line, cause they don't want nobody that's color out of the line, so I'm late as a motherfucker, color people time. Damn, easy, it all gotta be dimes. Well, Adam gave up a rib, so mine better be prime.
Oh my god, that's great too.
Kill me, I swear they better be lying. I never live in fear, I'm too out of my mind. Baby, baby, the night is young, what the fuck you wanna do, huh?
It's a cool beat, man. Really cool beat. What the fuck we gonna do, huh? I like this a lot. It's just unique, man. There's something different about it. Yeah, and it's got this change up right here. And it's like a little bit of distortion on the piano there. And there's a little bit of... Sounds like there's like a little bit of static on the drum, so it's got like a little bit of a lo-fi sound. And then that. That might be my favorite beat off the album. That was a cool, cool beat. Who produced this again? No ID? Yeah, that's fucking great, man. That was great. So there's Primetime, Basket in the Lime, Cassius in His Prime, which was Cassius Clay, Muhammad Ali. So I'm late as a motherfucker, colored people time. I love this though. Damn easy. They all gotta be dimes. Well, Adam gave up a rib. So mine better be prime. That is brilliant. Brilliant for saying his women have to be top notch. That's really well done right there. I never live in fear. I'm too out of my mind. when you coming home, that's a text for my wife. Good shit. That was a great track. Great track. Okay. Track 16. The final one here is going to be featuring Curtis Mayfield, produced by Kanye and Pete Rock, who I'm not familiar with. Oh, it looks like Kid Cudi is also on this too. Charlie Wilson, I don't know who that is. All right, track 16, The Joy.
Add a little sugar.
I wonder if Charlie Wilson's a sample. Oh no, Curtis Mayfield's a sample.
A great big expression of happiness. These are the makings.
I do it for the forefathers, yeah, the street authors. That are now A&Rs in the cheap office. Rappers that never get signed, but they keep offers. Girls is way too fine for us to keep offers. Gave her a handshake only for my man's sake. She in a birthday suit cause of the damn cake.
Nice line.
There's crumbs all over the damn place, and she want me to come all over her damn face. I never understood Planned Parenthood cause I never met nobody planned to be a parent in a hood.
The joy of children laughing around you. These are the makings.
So it's kind of interesting because the chorus, such would astound you, the joy of children laughing around you. These are all the makings of you. So I wonder if, you know, with this opening verse too, because talking about, you know, all the kids that he's not having. I wonder if this is a slight expression of, you know, regret. Like, man, maybe it'd be nice to have a couple more kids. I don't know. Girls, that's way too fine to keep off us. Wait. I said it wrong. They're way too fine for us to keep off us. Gave her a handshake only for my man's sake. She's in her birthday suit because of the damn cake, which is, I guess, because of money, right? That's what cake is money. Yeah. No, crumbs all over the damn place. She wants him to come all over her damn face. Oh, my God, man. Oh, my God. Never understood Planned Parenthood. I never met anybody planned to be a parent in the hood taking refills of Plan B. good shit. All right, let's keep going. The uns on the verse are distracting to me.
Nah, you ain't listen. They black. They sisters. Their mama named them after white bitches. So next time you see me on your fallopian, though the Druby's Egyptian, though the hunger's Ethiopian. Stupid questions like, is he gonna be dope again? Have you seen him? Has anybody spoke to him?
Yeah.
This beat deserves Hennessy, a bad bitch, and a bag of weed, the Holy Trinity.
This is my mama shit. I used to hear this through the walls in the hood when I was back on my pajama shit. Afros and marijuana sticks, seeds in the ganja, had it popping like the sample that I'm rhyming with. But you was raising the warrior, we victorious, they'll never take the joy from us.
Keep your hands up, get under, don't let them take your fire. Keep your hands up,
this is cool.
Don't let them take your fire. Keep your hands up,
kind of a funky electronic sound, huh? The rhythm of it is kind of funky. No, I like this. I like this outro quite a bit. It's just cool, you know? Just this guy's fucking around on the keyboard a little bit.
One, two, okay.
That was cool. I don't like that song. I like that song. I don't like all the It's just a little too much, which is too bad because I love the ending and I really like the beat and I like the lo-fi sound that's floating around in there. That was fucking great. God damn, dude. That's a really, really, really good album. I didn't really know what to expect. When I saw there was 16 tracks on the deluxe edition, I was like, oh, fuck, this might be, you know, it might drag on a little bit. But the production is so fucking phenomenal. Really, really good. And I think part of it is I'm just getting better at appreciating the production side. You know, I'm starting to read who's producing the beats and stuff like that. So I'm getting into that more finally. I know a lot of people have been kind of annoyed with I focus on the lyrics so much. I love lyrics, but you know, really it's not so much that they're mad about the lyrics, but I need to give the music more love, you know, the production more love. And I feel like I'm getting there now. This is a great album. Fuck, man. Like, I think I've got, I don't have a heart next to everything. There's a couple I don't have a heart next to, but man, production wise, holy shit. And then, you know, Jay-Z and Kanye are both just coming with these great lines, funny lines. I forget which track it was where I was saying how I was finally getting it, this idea of living vicariously through them. New Day is by far my favorite track off the album. Can I talk about it? Can I actually talk about it without crying? Probably, maybe. It's been long enough. I've kind of forgotten it now. I've heard enough songs since then. It really strikes me, you know, the use of Nina Simone and the music that she made and just powerful, powerful songs. I don't remember the lyrics now, so I can kind of talk about it in a general sense. But this, you know, idea of not going to repeat the mistakes my dad made. I'm going to be there for my kids. You know, I'm a father, so that strikes me very much. Great song. Great song. And then I remember the sound. I don't remember the beat right now, how it goes, but I remember the sound, just really enjoying the tone of that track a lot. That's My Bitch was a fucking great one, too. Individuals in Paris. That was a good one. Man, so much of it. Murder to Excellence was very good. Very good. Who's Gonna Stop Me? Why I Love You. Man, that fucking beat when it just goes boom, you just drop in, man. That was so cool. So cool. This is great. I really enjoyed this. I enjoyed this more than I thought I was. I didn't think, not that I thought it was gonna be bad. I mean, I was kind of excited with, you know, Jay-Z and Kanye. You go, okay, it's gonna at least clear a couple bars of expectation, you know. But shit, that was good. I can see why people are like, no, you gotta do that one. You gotta do that one, even though it's not technically a Kanye album, you know? And then two, to hear it where, at least where Kanye is in his life at this point in time, I don't know much about Jay-Z because he's got a bunch of albums. I haven't listened to any of them except for Reasonable Doubt. I do want to hear The Blueprint, I think is before this. And I believe the Black album is before this. I believe, I'm not positive. I don't know his discography at all. And really the only Jay-Z song I know is Big Pimpin'. Oh my God, I love that song. And there's a story that goes with it. I may have told it already. I'll tell it some other time if I get to that album. Or maybe I'll do a single. I don't know. Anyway, this is great. Really enjoyed that. Great production. Fantastic production. I'm going to go listen to it again. Yeah. You know, I'm curious right now because I'm going to listen to this again. And, you know, I'll do additional thoughts like I always do. And I feel like, I don't know if I'll have that much else to say. You know, oh, let me know if there's music videos. Put music videos if you guys know of music videos. Put them in the comments. But I kind of feel like, shit, this is one of those albums where you can hear it for the first time and go, yeah, that's it. Because the lyrics, it's not like I'm going to go through and take them apart and find deeper meanings or anything like that. You know, everything's pretty much there. It stands there. It's straightforward in terms of lyrics. And the music is great. The production, you know, there's not a story being told from, you know, throughout the album from song to song. Although, what's the deal with that circus music? That's very distinct, very intentional. It's being put in specific places. Let me know what the deal is with that. I don't know the circus music part. That was kind of interesting. Cool stuff. Glad I did that one. That was a great album. Really enjoyable. And yeah, I guess we'll see you guys later.